Next, a popular cafe further north has found a new home right smack in the middle of the metro. Watch this. Nestled in a cozy corner on the second floor of the modest Kalayaan Centerpoint building in Quezon City is Old Baguio Cafe, a quaint little coffee shop that captures the City of Pines in all its glory. From its wood and brick interiors, Ifugao wood carvings and vintage decor, to the sweet strawberry and savory Cordilleran dishes. This cafe is the epitome of homey Baguio and makes for a great meeting place for friends who want to catch up over a cup of coffee and a slice of strawberry shortcake, of course. Owners of Old Baguio Cafe's V Luna branch, Wendy Molina and John Palisok, launched the brand's very first cafe in the metro last year. And they weren't kidding when they said they wanted to bring a piece of Baguio into the metro.
For joining us again, John and Wendy. So tell us about how you both got into a coffee or making a coffee shop.
Actually, for me, it's more of a personal thing. Mm. And I grew up with my father drinking coffee. I don't know, since I was a kid. So I will wake up with the aroma of his freshly brewed coffee in the morning. And then since then, I've been drinking coffee since I was a kid.
We participated in numerous exhibits and expos. And that's where we found Old Baguio Cafe. In the March of 2019, the Franchise Asia Expo, we went there. We fell in love with the concept because it shared like 95% of what we want. So it has the vibe of having that old Baguio concept itself, the Baguio, the entire Cordillera market, the idea of bringing those coffee from the time of how it was even, or how it even started back in the Session Rows before SM went there. So there were like around five generations of coffee shops in there, and then they told us about the story. And actually, we liked it because it's like five generations of coffee shops which are now gone.
Wiped out.
Why? Because of the market itself. They weren't able to cope up with the market, I would say.
Opening a cafe during a pandemic when the dining scene struggled to survive was no easy feat for the owners. But they were determined to keep the business afloat regardless of the circumstances. They sold mixed vegetables and fresh strawberries to make ends meet. But it was not until they started reselling viscous strawberry shortcake that the owners finally saw a glimmer of hope amid the gloom of uncertainty. Old Baguio Cafe quickly became a favorite among coffee drinkers and dessert lovers, thanks to its premium brews locally sourced from Atok Benguet, and equally indulgent cakes from Baguio's much-loved Viscose Bake Shop.
When the cakes were already picked up, we thought of a way, how can we promote our cafe with those cakes? And that's when we encourage pick up. So they can see our cafe, and we offer them, like, if you pick up your cake in our cafe, we'll give you a free coffee.
Yeah, of your choice. Because we wanted to show them the place.
Customers who picked up their cakes from the coffee shop were treated to a nice cup of joe, which helped people to take notice of their impressive menu, packed full of delectable Cordilleran dishes. One of the highlights is the classic pinik pikan made with smoked pork, native chicken, and a selection of healthy, sustainably sourced vegetables. This native dish has become a local staple, helping the Cordilleran stay warm in the cold Highlands weather. The cafe's zesty take on the quintessential hinudai, which is smoked pork mixed with bell pepper, lemon, and orange, is an absolute must try. As well as the wholesome Cordilleran omelette, an all-day breakfast dish made with scrambled eggs and smoked pork, served with a generous cup of red rice and garnished with fresh fruits and vegetables. If you still have room, we suggest sampling the Cordilleran mix of sautéed pork, meat, and liver for a more diverse flavor. Whether you're a coffee aficionado or just curious to try, you can get your caffeine fix from a decent cup of smooth, high-quality Arabica drip. Drop a sugarcane candy in your hot coffee, which will dissolve into a drink for a more pleasant experience. Speaking of sweets, here's a selection of Instagrammable house specialties, meticulously crafted to satisfy the taste buds as much as the eyes, like this decadent strawberry-flavored tajo with slices of fresh strawberries on top. If you want to try the best of both Cordilleran brews and Baguio's fresh produce, we recommend their strawberry espresso yogurt, which combines the healthy yogurt with strawberry puree and shots of single-origin Arabica espresso. The strawberry champurrado topped with walnuts and almonds is also equally mouth-watering. Aside from the menu, the shop is also filled with a plethora of souvenir items from Baguio, like these bamboo mugs, kitchen utensils, and woven baskets that blend with the cafe's theme and rustic design. They also offer other pasalubong goods which customers can purchase if they decide to bring a little slice of Baguio into their homes. The vibrant coffee table and wooden dining sets are perfect for either working or socializing. So pull up a chair, and if you're lucky, you'll be able to listen to live jazz music while having your fill of sumptuous Cordilleran cuisine. In addition to partnering with local coffee farmers, most of the staff come from Abra and Benguet, so the cafe is not just about the coffee beans and culinary heritage. It also aims to showcase the warm Cordilleran hospitality.
We're always telling them that when we go to the cafe, what we provide is what we wanted to share to our patrons, to the metro community, is the best of the Cordilleran hospitality. So it's sharing our culture, tradition, and heritage. It's literally sharing a piece of our home in the metro.
Yes, because we try to recreate at least what are the things that you can come up with found in the house of people who live in the Baguio. So we do have fireplace, even though it's not cold in there. So we have that. We have this wood products that they have. The coffee from the Atok Benguet, which actually we love the most. Why? Because this were the coffee, it was one of the greatest coffee that won an award.
From the welcoming rustic interiors to the excellent food and fantastic service, this quaint little spot in the metro is the closest we can get to the Highlands. While Old Baguio Cafe has alfresco dining, for now they're only open for takeout, pickup, and delivery. So give them a call before they run out of your favorite drink or meal. For this one gem of a cafe is well on its way to becoming the next steady fixture in the local cafe scene.